Hello guys, welcome. In this new tutorial of Blender 2.8, I will gonna show you how you can create a fruit ball with some apples on it and a napkin. For this tutorial we will gonna use some modifiers like cloth modifier, and we will gonna use too, I will give you the basics of proportional editing, okay? I am using, as I said before, Blender 2.8. You can download it from www.blender.org, and if you look at the bottom left of the screen, you can see that the keys and the buttons of the mouse that I am clicking will be logged in order to help you during this tutorial. Let's start. I have here the main scene, the default scene of Blender, with a cube, a camera and a light, okay? First let's remove the cube because we will not need it for this tutorial. Click on it to select and press the delete or the X key, okay? Now the cube is selected. Let's start to create the fruit ball. For that you can press Shift A and add a cylinder. I prefer to use the shortcut keys, but you have the menus where you can add the mesh that you want. The shortcut keys are harder in the beginning, but after you have some experience on it, they will be faster to work. So in this tutorial I will gonna preferentially use the shortcut keys, okay? Now that we have a cylinder, you can go here to the cylinder properties that we have created, and let's define the number of vertices. By default they are 32, but for this case we will gonna use 8, okay? Now that we have our cylinder with 8 vertices, we need to go to edit mode, press tab to enter in edit mode, and now let's remove the top face. You go here to select the face, this one, and press the delete or the X key, and then select faces. Now we need to make the base smaller and the top larger. For that it is better that if we work in the front view. To go to the front view you can click 1 on your numpad, okay, or you can go here to the menu and select here the front, the bottom, what you want. For this case we will gonna use the front, and then click here to select the edges. For this case we will select the top edges. To do that you just need to click on Alt to select all this loop here of faces, and then click in one random face, okay? Now that we have all that faces selected, go to click on one to go to front mode, to front view, I'm sorry, and then press S to scale it. Okay, I think that this is good. Let's press one again because I have left the front view. I have clicked on the middle mouse of the button, okay, and then let's select all the mesh. You can press A, and then let's move it to the to this X axis, okay? Press G and then Z to lock it over the Z axis, okay? Let's place it here. I think that is good. Now that we have our fruit ball created, Let's add a modifier because, as you can see, if you look at the bottom of the fruit ball, it have not any thickness. So let's add some thickness to it. You can go here to this button to go to modifiers tab, select add modifier, and then let's click on solidify. Okay, on solidify, let's adjust this value where it says thickness, and let's give some values to it. I think that 0.6 is good. Next thing that we need to do is to create an apple. Let's just move by pressing G and then X the fruit ball over here. Now shift A, or you can go to the menu, add a sphere. Okay, as in the fruit ball, in the same way that the fruit ball has by default 32 segments, the sphere has 32 segments too. I think that this value for this case is acceptable. Okay, so we will not change that. Let's press S to scale it, and now click on Tab to go to edit mode. Now that we have a sphere created, to give the shape of an apple, all the things that we need to do is to create two holes, one on the top and another one on the bottom. For doing that, you just need to select the top edge, go to one. No, maybe I will not go yet to front mode because I want to show you one thing first. If you click on the vertices and then press G to move these vertices, as you can see, it only moves the vertices that is selected. Okay, the vertex that is selected. We don't want to do that. We want to move this vertex and all the other ones that are near to it. Okay, to do that, we will gonna use one thing that is called proportional editing. So the first thing that you need to do is first to enable it. Okay, click on here and then select the shape that you want. You can use one that you think it's better. You can try all of them, there is no problem at all. For this case, smooth I think that will work, and sharp I think that will work too. Let's try sharp for this case and then press G and Y to move it on the, I'm sorry, and Z to move it on the Z axis. And then, as you can see, all the vertices near to this selected one, all the vertex, I'm sorry, near to this selected one will move with it. Okay, to increase the number of vertices that will move, you can rotate your mouse wheel, and this little circle that appears on the screen will increase, and this will tell you how much vertices will move. For this case, let's reduce it a little bit. I just want maybe let's hit escape. I will do it again. Let's press G and Z. Okay, maybe I have made with a few vertices. I want with more vertices, so let's undo it again. Press G, increase the wheel, and then Z to move it on the Z axis. I think that is better now. Let's do the same for the bottom. Select, okay, press G and hit Z, and then pull this up. Okay, now let's make the top with log, little log, I don't know how you can call that. Press tab, shift A, mesh, let's add another cylinder, press G to move it here, and then let's hit tab to go to edit mode, select the top face, and then press E to extrude. Okay, let's press E again and E again. Now press G to move. Let's disable the proportional editing for this case, or we can make it enabled, there is no problem. Let's just select smooth here, press G, increase. Okay. And now press R to rotate. I think that is fine. Let's disable. Press S to scale top a little bit. Okay. And now select all the mesh by clicking on A and S. Go to the front view by clicking on 1, press S, and then press G to move it to the apple. I think that is too big, so let's press S again and make it smaller, and then go to this face here, select this face here, press E to extrude it again and Z on Z axis. Okay, now as you can see we have the bottom of the top of the apple, but it is not centered yet with the apple, so let's press 7 to go to top view, select all by clicking on A and then G to move it to the center. Okay, press 1, 7. Okay, that is good. Let's move it down a little bit, press G and then Z. Okay, I think that is nice. You can rotate it, just make it at your own taste. Okay, what you think is good is perfectly acceptable, is okay. And now let's add some modifiers on it. Let's click on tab to exit edit mode. For the apple, let's use the subdivision. What subdivision does is that subdivision surface multiplicates all the polygons present on the mesh by 4. So increase it will give it a more smooth look. Okay, let's select 2 and then let's add the smooth shade smooth. Okay, now the surface is good. Let's do the same for the top subdivision. Let's make it 2. And then, as you can see, in the result here, that's not what we want. To correct that, we need to add some edges on the bottom. So let's enter edit mode again by clicking on tab. Okay, you can hit Ctrl R to subdivide here, and then move it down. Okay, let's click on tab to exit in the edit mode, and then we can add the smooth to this object too. Okay, that's better. Now that we have our apple and our fruit ball created, let's add some plane here. Shift A, plane, press S. I want it to be bigger, much bigger, so let's press S and then click on 50. That's okay, that's good. And now let's move the apple inside of the fruit bowl. To do that, click on one to go to front view, select that two objects and press G. Compared to the fruit bowl, I think that the apple is too big, so press S to scale it to this size. I think that is good, and then click on one and let's move it, pressing G to the other size. Okay, and now let's rotate it a little bit, press R to rotate. Let's go to the front view first, press R. Okay, that's good, press G and you can leave it here. Now let's add some textures to it. For the fruit ball we will gonna use glass, and for the apple we will gonna use a texture of an apple. I have two textures here that I have downloaded for the internet, off the internet, I'm sorry. One of them is the apple texture and the other one is the texture that we will gonna use later on the napkin. You can download them from the description of this video. I will left the link there. Let's go to Blender and first let's add the texture to the fruit wall. To do that, go to this tab here, shading tab. Okay, make sure that you have the fruit wall selected, then go here to this button. Okay, it says material and click on new to add new material. Next thing that you need to do is to remove this node here. We will not gonna use them. We want a simple glass texture. So we're gonna add the node of the glass texture. Select it and press the delete or the X key. Shift A, shader, glass BHDF, and then connect the BHDF to the surface of your output. Okay, and now that we have glass created and applied to the object, let's add the texture to the apple. Click on new and then we will maintain this node. We just need to add another one, the image. Click shift A, texture, and image texture. Okay, now click on open to open the texture. I have placed the texture on my desktop, so click here and then apple texture. Okay, all you need to do is to connect and now we have the texture of the apple. Maybe it is too glossy, so I will increase the number of roughness here. That is good. And now let's give, let's try to make this look like wood, a wood stick. I remember now the name, wood stick. Click on new. For this case, we will just gonna use some color. Let's increase the roughness again, because I don't want it to be glossy. And then for the base color, let's use maybe brown color, okay? I think that is okay. And now the next phase is to design the napkin. First, let's just duplicate the apples. Let's make it two. So select those two objects, press Shift D to duplicate, and then place it where you want. I will place it here. Let's just press G. The place where you put the apples is up to you. Let's duplicate. Maybe three will look better. So select the object, Shift D, and then let's put the third one over here. Maybe on the other side, I'm sorry. I think they are good. Okay. Now let's create the napkin. The napkin is a simple shape. It's a plane. So let's press Shift A, mesh plane. Okay. G and Z to move it up. And then let's press R to rotate. Let's rotate it over the X. And then over the y-axis. Okay, now let's scale it. I want it to be like this, and then press 7 to go to top. G, let's place it here, and then 1. Let's go to the side view. Okay. I think that is good. And now, first we will gonna apply the texture to the napkin, and then we will gonna use the cloth modifier, so that we will not make the shape of a napkin from scratch. Blender has modifiers that can do that for you. And I will gonna show it to you. But first, let's go to the shading, to this tab here, and add a texture. Let's create new. Let's maintain this node here. Just add a picture node, a texture node, I'm sorry. Click on open. And then select and connect it here. Now let's start to add the modifiers to the napkin. Okay, please pay attention to this part. It is the most complex part of the tutorial. So the first modifier that we're gonna add is a cloth modifier. Okay, I will show you the properties of the cloth later. I am just adding it now because the importance of the sequence that we add modifiers is very important. So let's add then a subdivision or solidify. Let's add a solidify and then a subdivision surface. Okay, now as you can see, after I have added the subdivision, it have lost its original shape, but that's no problem. We will gonna click on it, go to edit mode, and for the napkin, we will need to add some segments, okay, some edges. For this case, I will try maybe 50, so press Control R, Control R, I'm sorry, and when appears this line over here, you can click and then 50. Sorry, Control R. Okay, then press 50 on your numpad and hit enter. And you can place it where you want. And then press Control R again, 50, and hit enter. And we can place it just like this. Okay, go to tab to exit edit mode, and then for the thickness, we will gonna use 0.1. Now let's add the cloth properties to it. Okay, go here to this tab. As you can see, we have already selected the cloth because that's a modifier that we have applied before. Okay, click here and select cotton. Increase the quality steps to 10. Okay, now let's go here to the collision properties, increase this to 5. Make sure you have object collision selected and self collision, you need to select it too. Okay, I think that over here we don't need to do anything more. Now let's select the plane, click on this tab, and activate the collision. Okay, this will avoid that the napkin passes through the plane. Okay, make sure that you have unselect the single-sided, and now make the same for the ball and for the apples. Okay, I think that you can select all the objects. No, you can't. Yes, you need to make it one by one. I could join those objects, but I don't think that we will gonna need it. That will not make any difference. Okay. Now that we have our objects created, we can click here, and with all the properties that we want, we can click here to see how our animation will work. Let's press play. And then, as you can see, the napkin is is transforming to the shape that we want. Okay, I just need to make some changes here, so let's pause it. Let's click here to go to the first frame. The first thing that we need to do, let's add some smooth on it, and then I think that we'll need to increase it. Okay, it is too smaller. Let's press G. I think that is good now. Let's see how it will work. Press play. You can stop when you think that is good. I will left him flow. Okay, I think the animation it takes too long, so I will do something before. Let's go to the first frame again, and here on the napkin, let's increase the speed multiplier by 4. Okay, let's press play. Okay, too much fast, but I think it's all gonna be okay. And now let's pause it. As you can see, there are some glitches here. The napkin have passed through this edge. We can try to correct this by, I don't know, increasing the thickness here, 0.2 to point, or inner thickness in this case, 2.4. Let's see how it will work. I think that it is good. Now let's see our scene with some textures. You just need to go here to the render mode, click here. But first, I prefer to use cycles in this tutorial, okay? So make sure that you have cycles selected. Click here. And as you can see, we have our scene. Let's just move the light to here. Let's go to the light properties, click here to use nodes, and then let's increase the strength to 14. And now let's go to the world properties and change the background to black, because I want it to be all black. Let's see how. Okay, it is start to looking good. Let's just increase the light maybe to 600. And that's pretty much it. Now you can left, or you can render your high quality scene. I will just leave it here so that you can see the final aspect of the picture. I hope that you have liked my tutorial, and sometimes excuse my English, because it's not my native language, so sometimes I have to think what I will gonna say. If you have liked it, please subscribe my channel. For this scene, you can later add some lights to improve the results, or have some new textures, anything that you want. This tutorial was just an example where we have used different kinds of modifiers and methods so that you can learn a little bit more of Blender. I hope that you have liked it again, and I see you soon.